We welcome you to our evening of shadows. I'd like to inform you of the nature of this service. This is a somber service. It means that it's a service that is surrounded in silence and quiet. It's commemorating the suffering of Jesus, what he went through on the cross. It's a service that's marked with reflection and the diminishing of light. After the service, we ask that you would leave in silence. During the service, we ask that you stay in silence. We also are giving you time at the end of the service to have silent prayer for about 10 minutes if you so desire before we close the sanctuary down. This evening, you'll notice that there are people who are coming up and doing scripture readings. They will also be saying a prayer. And then there will be a moment of silence where we will have the candles being extinguished as our evening gets darker and darker. It's an evening of shadows. It walks us through scripture and Jesus's crucifixion and death at Calvary. And as we go through this evening of readings and prayer and listening and the candles being extinguished, we will be entering the shadows. And we pray here at Central Baptist that you will feel the love Christ had for you and has for you, as we see the shadows that he endured before we see the joy of Easter morning. So let us begin with our call to worship. You will see that it is in your bulletin. It's the only time that we will be saying anything together this evening. All you who pass this way,
look and see the shadow of sin.
All you who pass this way,
look and see the weight of the world.
All you who pass this way,
look and see the suffering of our Savior.
All you who pass this way,
look and see the sorrow of Jesus Christ.
Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Let us pray. Jesus, our Lord and our God, you gave your cheek to those who struck you, and for our sake you endured much mockery. Grant that following the example of your sufferings, we may be courageous in bearing our own and learn from you, for you are meek and lowly in heart. You now reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Our shadows now begin to descend upon us.
One in the sorrows must
The shadow of condemnation. The reading is from Luke chapter 23, verses 32 through 34. Two others, criminals, were also led away to be executed with him. When they arrived at the place called the Skull, they crucified him there, along with the criminals, one on the right and one on the left. Then Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, because they do not know what they are doing." And they divided his clothes and cast lots. And her prayer, forgiving Christ, when the world condemns us, when wrong is done to us, when we carry the weight of things that are too much to forgive, come along beside us in the darkness, and give us the grace to be forgiven and forgiving.
Because you are forsaken, Shadow of Separation. This is a reading from Luke chapter 23, verses 35 through 43. The people stood watching, and the rulers even sneered at him. They said, "He saved others. Let him save himself if he is God's Messiah, the chosen one." The soldiers also came up and mocked him. They offered him wine vinegar and said, "If you are the king of the Jews, save yourself." There was a written notice above him which read, "This is the king of the Jews." One of the criminals who hung there hurled insults at him. "Aren't you the Messiah? Save yourself and us." But the other criminal rebuked him. "Don't you fear God?" he said, "since you are under the same sentence. We are punished justly, for we are getting what our deeds deserve. But this man has done nothing wrong." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." Jesus answered him, "Truly I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise." Let us pray. Reconciling Christ, we are weighed down by sin and separation, a world that is not at peace, people who are not whole. You reached out to the thief. You welcomed him to God's side. Come alongside us in the darkness and bring grace and peace to everything that is broken.
Thank you. Today's reading is The Shadow of Sorrows. This is in John chapter 19, verse 25 to 27. Near the cross of Jesus stood his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother there, and the disciple whom he loved standing nearby, he said to her, "Woman, here is your son." And to the disciple, "Here is your mother." And from that time on, the disciple took her into his home. Prayer today is, loving Jesus, we carry the weight of the people we love. Concern for their sorrows and suffering. Our care for them is deep, and sometimes there is not much we can do. Come alongside us in the darkness and cradle the ones we love in your strong hands.
Sometimes marriages don't work, and sometimes babies die. Sometimes rehab turns to relapse, and you're left just asking why. And for all the prayers I've prayed, I still wonder if he's real. And if he is, how is he choosing who he does and doesn't need? And I've burned my share of bridges. I've learned to tuck my tail and run. Watch the wreckage in the rearview from all the crooked things I've done. And I know that he forgives me, but it's hard to forgive myself. I can't help but think that amazing grace is for everybody else. And I know I wasn't there, but when I look up at the cross, I see the darkest day in history. I guess that's what kindness cost. I've tried to run from Jesus, I've started holy wars, I've tried the patient way. Never changed his mind.
Shadow of despair, reading Mark 5:33-34. Then the woman, knowing what happened to her, came and fell at his feet, trembling with fear, told the whole truth. He said to her, "Daughter, your faith has healed you. Go in peace and be freed from your suffering." Let's pray. Lord Jesus Christ, you know what it is to feel that God is far away. You know what it is to call out for God's presence. Come alongside us in the darkness and help us call out for God.
Shadow of suffering. This reading is from John
19 verses 28 through 30. Later, knowing that everything had now been finished and so that scripture would be fulfilled, Jesus said, "I am thirsty." A jar of wine vinegar was there, so they soaked a sponge in it, put the sponge on a stalk of the hyssop plant, and lifted it to Jesus' lips. When he had received the drink, Jesus said, "It is finished." With that, he bowed his head and gave up his spirit. Let us pray. Suffering Savior, in all our thirst, in all our sickness, in all our longing, in all our pain, you are there. Come alongside us in the darkness and walk with us through all our suffering.
The Shadow of Death. This reading is Luke chapter 23, verse 44 to 49. It was now about noon, and the darkness came over the entire land all wind until 3 in the afternoon. For the sun stopped shining, and the curtain of the temple was torn in two. Jesus called out with a loud voice, "Father, into your hands I commit my spirit." When he had said this, he breathed his last. When the centurion, seeing what had happened, praised God, said, "Surely this was a righteous man." When all the people who had gathered to witness this sight saw what took place, they beat their breasts and went away. But all those who knew him, including the woman who had followed him from Galilee, stood at a distance watching these things. Let us pray. Dearest Jesus, even in death, you are there. Even when we mourn, when we are afraid, when we come to our own end, you have been there too. Come alongside us in the darkness and carry us through death to life.
Take this heart.